Welcome, my name is Jason Johnson, and thank you for watching this video. I hope you find my videos helpful, and thank you for subscribing to my channel. If you have a question, you can leave a comment below, and I'll answer you as quick as possible, or I'll try to point you in the right direction. This video is going to cover NETICAD CCNA Course 1, Lab 1245, 1.2.4.5, I think is the right way to say it, using Packet Tracer, and we're going to look at network representation. So let's open up the PKA file. Now you'll be able to get these PKA files and PDF files from the NETICAD course, Cisco NETICAD RNS Routing and Switching Course 1 is what this lab goes to. So let's open up this PKA file here for Packet Tracer. And you can get a copy of Packet Tracer by going to the NETICAD course. And most likely, if you're watching this video, you're one of my students and you already have this. So I'm going to go ahead and close this piece down here. That's the representation of the lab. And I've already got it in a PDF form here in a larger format here. So this is going to be our topology that we're looking at here. And I'm going to scroll on down to our objectives. And in this objective for this lab, the network model is going to incorporate many of the technologies that you master in your CCNA studies and going towards your CCNA certification. This one's going to represent a simplified version of how a small to medium-sized business network might look. You know, just an example. So feel free to explore around on it. It gives you a good starting lab to be able to click on different devices, be able to get familiar with the Packet Tracer course, and hopefully you took the Packet Tracer course. I know if you're one of my students, you did take the Packet Tracer course because I do require that for the RNS course 1. And it's not important that you understand everything you see and do in this activity. That's the main thing to remember. Just make sure you're exploring and understanding how to move around in Packet Tracer and what a network looks like in Packet Tracer. So step one, we're going to identify common components of a network as represented in Packet Tracer. So the icon toolbar at the bottom left-hand corner has various categories of networking components. You should see categories that correspond to intermediary devices, end devices, and media. And I'm just going to pause here and make a note that when I'm talking about these different this terminology, you should reference the videos that accompany the CCNA course. Those are in another playlist, and I'll have a link to that in the description on this video below. The connections category, so let's go back to what we're reading here. The connections category with the lightning bolt represents the networking media supported by Packet Tracer. And there's also an end devices category and two categories specific to Packet Tracer, custom-made devices and multi-user connection. So first we need to list the intermediary device categories is what it's wanting us to do. So if we list the intermediary device categories, we just come in here to our Packet Tracer, and we're going to open this up. And if we come down here to our intermediary down here, and if we're looking at these different devices, see, we have our network devices, we have our end devices, our components, our connections, miscellaneous, multi-user, here's our routers, switches, hubs, wireless, security, and WAN emulation, and these are going to be our intermediary devices down here. So if we look at that, these are our routers, switches, hubs, and so if you're doing the lab, that's what you'll want to fill in right there. Okay, so step B here, without entering into the internet cloud or intranet cloud, how many icons in the topology represent endpoint devices? Only one connection leading to them. And you may not know what an endpoint device is. I'm just going to say that's a device with only one connection leading to them. If you study the course material, you're going to read more about endpoint devices. So if we look at our topology here, and I'm going to try to make this let me move this around here, and I'll just have to scroll this up and down. So if we look at our endpoint devices, and I'm going to use my pen here. So if we look at our endpoint devices here, that's with one leading to them. An endpoint device is going to be something like a desktop or a laptop, an inkjet printer here that we have, a tablet. Those are endpoint devices. So if you count those, that's going to give you your number. So, you know, you've got four there. You know, there's a branch server. That's an endpoint device. And then you just go through and count all of these. A wireless AP is not an endpoint device. That's an intermediary device. A router, you know, that we have right here is an intermediary device. That is not an endpoint device. So you want to count all those endpoint devices and put that number in there. And then without counting the two clouds, How many icons in the topology represent intermediary devices? Multiple connections leading to them. And I just kind of gave you a hint on that on intermediary devices there. If we're looking at that, intermediary devices, and let me make this a little bit, let me drop this and make this. There we go. It's a little bit easier for me to scroll back and forth there. And intermediary devices are devices that connect endpoint devices. So if we're looking at that, you're looking at, you know, a router there, wireless router there, modem, intermediary device. It said not to count the cloud. So we're not going to count this one, and we're not going to count those devices in there because we really don't know how many devices are in the cloud. But we know we've got that one and that one there and our wireless AP. And would an IP phone be an intermediary device? That's a good question. I'm not going to give you the answer to that here in this video, but you might want to check that out. It's got more than one connections going into it, so it doesn't necessarily follow that previous endpoint device, but it is a phone, much like a computer. It's just being able to use, you know, send information out, and it's not really an intermediary device. Okay, so then back to routers and a switch there, and we go four. So you should be able to answer that question fairly easily. And E, how many end devices are not desktop computers? You want to answer that question. That was fairly easy. So just go through and say, you know, that's a desktop computer there. So count the ones that are not desktop computers. So you should be able to answer that one fairly easily. And then how many different types of media connections are used in this network topology? And so this one's going to be a little bit more difficult because you have to say how many different types of media. So you're looking at the different types of media here and you're saying, okay, well, I've got a tablet. That's one type. That's a mobile device. I've got a laptop. Is that a mobile device or is that a laptop? Does that fall into a different category? So you might want to clarify that with your instructor on how they want to say, you know, is a laptop and a tablet different on that? Are they both considered mobile devices? I would say no, a tablet's a mobile device and a laptop is a laptop and a mobile computing. Desktops, you have printers, that's one. You know, here's another mobile device here, a smartphone and a tablet. I would put them in the same category. But again, clarify that with your instructor for the NetAcad course because they may have a different definition of that on that. So you want to make sure if you're in my class, I'm definitely going to count those in the same category of mobile computing. However, you want to check with your instructor. So you want to say how many different types of media connections are used in this network topology? How many different types of media connections are used in this network topology? And if we go back to this, so we look at the different types here. So we can see when we're looking at our media devices here, and we click here, we've got our different ones, and we can see that this is a serial DCE, serial DTE. This one's a phone connection, old pot, the POTS line. This one is that one is a fiber, copper crossover, copper straight through, a console cable, and an automatic connection. So if we look at these and we say, okay, we know we've got wireless here. Let me just do a little draw. We got wireless here. We've got a copper straight through there. We've got serial here, wireless there. So that's the same type. And then maybe down, you know, and then just check your different connections and you can count those up. Oh, you've got a different one there, which is it's our blue down here, which is our coax. So we have coax going from our modem out to our ISP. Okay. So that's step one. Step two, you want to explain the purpose of the devices, and this is going to be on your own here. I'm just going to give you a hint real quick. In Packet Tracer, only the server Packet Tracer device can act as a server. Desktop and laptop PCs cannot act as a server. Based on your study so far, explain the client-server model. And you want to explain the client-server model. A note of caution here, if you're studying networking, like for the Network Plus for CompTIA, the client-server model will be a little bit different description, and you know, just with the caveat here, a client server could be two endpoint devices. However, in Packet Tracer and in your studies in this course, desktop and laptop PCs cannot act as a server. So if you're looking at just generalized networking where you have one device serving up information to another device, that's a client server role. However, what we're talking about in the context of Packet Tracer, they're saying desktop, laptops, and mobile devices cannot act as servers. So you want to say that only the server devices can act as servers in this case for the Packet Tracer modeling. And so based on your studies, explain that client-server model role. So you just want to give an explanation of the client-server, how one device serves information to another device. For example, you might have a and let's just look here. We have a central server, and we may have files on that central server. And so a computer down here would retrieve files from that server. And then you just want to explain that model. And you want to list at least on step B, 2B here, you want to list at least two functions of intermediary devices. One function is routing, your routing information. Provide connection, that's another one. There's a few of them. And step 2C, list at least two criteria for choosing a network media type. And here I'll give you one is cost. So you want to look at cost. When you study the material in the NetAcad course, it's going to explain that because, for example, putting serial connections in is more expensive than putting coax in, a regular copper cable. Versus you might have wireless. Maybe you can't get wires. Location might be another example on there as a hint. Let's move to step three here. Compare and contrast LANs and WANs. And in the material for this course, you're gonna have information about what a LAN is and what a WAN is. A local area network. You're gonna have a local area network versus a wide area network, and local area networks being those networks that are contained in a small location. And when I say small location, that could be a building. I mean, you can have hundreds of devices on a local area network. So don't just think that it has to be a lab with 20 computers. It could be 100 computers on a local area network. But what you want to do is you want to read the material in the course and explain the difference between a LAN and a WAN. And in the packet tracer network, how many WANs do you see? And so this is an interesting exercise that we do here. So you need to understand what a WAN is, a wide area network. So when we look at our lab here, we know we have local area networks which are contained. So this would probably be a local area network here. This would be a local area network. This would be one. And intranet and intranet would be our wide area networks. So you want to count those and put that number in there. And in packet tracer, how many WANs do you see? Step 3C, how many LANs do you see? And you want to count those up. I've had some discussions in my face-to-face courses that I teach about a local area network. Would a connection here, would this be a local area network right there? Because you've got an IP address. You have IP addressing that only those two devices can see each other. You might have another one here. You might have another one here. If you're doing subnetting, those are certainly going to be considered separate subnets. So you want to clarify with your instructor whether they mean subnets or local area networks. I know what I've told my students, and if you're taking this for my class, I would count those as local area networks because you would have to subnet those. So if we're looking at those, we would subnet those out, and I would consider those local area networks. Okay, for step 3D, the internet in this packet tracer network is oversimplified. It does not represent the structure and form of the real internet, of course, obviously. So you want to just briefly describe the internet, and that's a huge question, but just briefly describe the internet in a sentence or two. Ask your instructor how much information they want on this question. For my students taking my class, I would say a sentence or two, maybe three sentences. Just describe the internet and what it does and what it provides and how it connects. And about three sentences should be enough. And then step 3E, what are some common ways a home user connects to the internet? A home user would connect. And so if we look here, we look at our home office here. This gives us some examples. You might have mobile devices, which is wireless. You might have wired connections. You might have Bluetooth connections. You might have which is still wireless, but you would be connecting through maybe Bluetooth or wireless. So what are some kind of common ways? Again, clarify with your instructor how many different ones they want on there. And then step 3F, we on 3F? Yes, 3F. What are some common methods that businesses use to connect to the internet in your area? And this one is just, you can look at this topology here or you can do some research and you can see, okay, how do businesses connect to the internet? Usually an ISP, internet service provider. That's one example. So you want to look up some other ones there. Okay, well, let's switch gears and look at the challenge here. So we've had an opportunity to explore the network represented in the packet tracer activity, and let's just go and take a look at this real quick. We can explore these different devices here. Let's take a look at our home desktop here. We can open this up. We can look at our actual physical device here. We can go in and we can look at the configuration on it. We can go in here and we can look at our IP configuration, and that is getting an IP static IP address that's been assigned to there. DHCP. Our DHCP server is going to that link local address there, but we're getting that. Our attributes there, our software services, we're not into that, but we look at our desktop there. Let's go and look at our router here, router 4. We can go and look at that, and let's just go ahead and open that up. And I'm going to just go ahead and go directly to the command line. I'm not going to use a console. And we're going to look at this. This has been, probably Cisco. I'm sure most of the passwords. I'm fat-fingering here. Maybe it's not. There we go. Yeah, there we go. It's class. It's either class or Cisco for our labs here. So I get in there and we can look at our router. We can look at our four here. We can show interface up. We can look at our information on our router and look at that. You're not to that point if you're doing this lab yet, but you can look around at it. We can look at our logical network here. We can also go in, and you should have learned about Packet Tracer on doing this. We can go into our physical here, and we can come in here. We can look at our home office, and we can look at our home office here and look at our this represents here, what that represents. So on your challenge here, you can add it, and you want to check with your instructor on whether they want you to do this challenge part. I encourage my students to do it, but it's not part of the graded portion of this. If you look down at the grading here, that's not part of the grading, but I'm just going to cover it here in the video real quick so that my students know what we're talking about. You can add an end device to the topology and connect it to one of the LANs with a media connection. So let's just do that real quick. And it's going to make this video a little bit longer, but I think it'll help you out a little bit. So if we're going to connect an end device, let's say that we want to connect another computer to our home office. So we're just going to come down here and click on our end devices. And let's just say that we want to put another computer in, and we're going to stick that right there. And then we're going to come to our cables here, and we're going to just direct copper straight through. And we're going to connect that to our fast Ethernet, and we're going to come into our wireless hub here. And we've got two open Ethernet ports, so I'm just going to plug that one into number 3, and it should get an IP address from the DHCP server. I'm going to fast forward time there, and there we go. It's up and running, and so I've added a device on there. And can you provide the information? You know, what else does this device need to send data to other users? Well, at this point, it doesn't need anything because it's automatically received. Let's go to IP configuration. Well, it doesn't because it's got a static IP address. I can't ping anything because I haven't assigned an IP address yet. So you want to look at that. You have to assign an IP address or turn the DHCP on. And is there a way to verify that you connected correctly connected to another device? That would be using a ping software. You would want to ping another. You would want to go in and ping. And I'm not going to show you in this lab, but you'll learn that in other labs. But you can ping maybe your modem or ping your default gateway is one way. You can add another intermediate device to one of the networks and connect it to one of the LANs or WANs with a media connection. Then what else does this device need? And that's going to be your IP addressing and that information. But you know, that's where you would just come down here on your intermediary devices. And let's just say I'm going to put another router in. Let's just say that we want to put another router in here, and we just got to put it on there. And then we could connect that with if it's got serial connectors, we can do that. We can also connect that with just a copper straight through. And we can do that on the gigabit Ethernet here. And then we can go in here and put that into the other Ethernet port there. And it's, you know, gigabit here. It's, yeah, that's all we've got there. So gigabit there. And then if we try to fast forward time and get that, of course, see, it's not coming up because I've not assigned IP addresses. And so let's just say I maybe want to pull this PC over here and put that connection into that router like that. See, and then now that won't come up yet either because I don't have any DHCP, I don't have any IP addressing set or anything. So I'd have to configure this router first before it would operate. Okay, and the last step here is open up a new instance of Packet Tracer, create a new network with at least two LANs connected by a WAN. Ask your instructor if they want you to do this step here. You can do it on your own. For my students, I'm not going to ask you to do that, but this would just be where you would open up a new, I'm not going to save this here. You would just open up a new packet tracer, and you would just create your own network. So you can set your route, put your routers in place. You can put your end devices in place, put your switches in, do all your cabling and so forth. Okay, so this has been the NetAcad CCNA course 1, the lab 1.2.4.5. Again, my name is Jason Johnson. I hope you enjoyed this video. I hope it was helpful for you. And subscribe to my channel if you have not. And ask any questions down below in the comments, and I'll get back with you as quick as possible. Hope you have a great day.